for metrology and measurement subject. The remaining multiple choice questions on form measurement unit 4 is presented in this video. Surface roughness on a drawing is represented by, it is usually represented by triangles. So the answer is B. Surface roughness can be represented by triangles. Surface roughness is a measure of how a surface is polished. So average of vertical deviation from a nominal surface over a specified length of surface is called as surface roughness. A surface, even a polished, highly polished surface, may have some peaks and valleys. So, and the peaks and valleys can be, peaks and valleys are the surface roughness. The surface roughness can be measured. So it can be measured. It is also called as cutoff length. It is measured parallel to the direction of profile. Next question, the M and E system in metrology related with the measurement of surface roughness. Okay. M and E system in metrology related with the measurement of surface roughness. In surface roughness, three quantities can be measured. One is RA, then RQ, then RZ. So the center line average is called as RA, R suffix A, RA. That is, in this, we have to take all the peaks and valleys. There are some peaks and valleys. We have to take average of all the peaks and valleys, and it will give the value of RA over the over the whole surface. We have to take all the peaks and we have to measure all the peaks and valleys, and the RA value can be presented. Then root mean square. Here all the values, the root of all the values can be presented. It is called as root mean square. It is RQ. Then 10 point average method, it is RZ. In this, 5 peaks and 5 valleys have been taken and this average is taken, it is RZ. So RA, RQ and RZ values can be determined. That is called as surface roughness. Which of the following is not a direct surface roughness measuring instrument? For surface roughness measurement, Tomlinson surface meter, Taylor-Hobson Tallyserf, profilometer. The three instruments are used, and a wireless surface dynamometer is not a surface roughness measuring instrument. Okay, the measurement of surface pin is stylus probe instrument. The stylus probe instrument, it consists of a stylus and it is also a probe. It is called as a stylus or probe. And these methods enable to determine a numerical value of the surface finish of any surface. A skid or shoe which is drawn slowly over the surface either by hand or by motor drive. Okay, and the skid when moved over the surface follows its general contours and it moves up and down, and this will be the measure of the surface finish. A stylus or probe which moves over the surface with a skid, the stylus should be cone shaped with a spherical shape. This requires a micro geometrical form of the surface. As a stylus tracks the surface peaks and valleys, its vertical motion is converted into a time varying electrical signal and that represents the surface profile. So this is a working of surface roughness measurement. All other instruments works based on this principle. So profilometer, it consists of an induction coil, a permanent magnet and induction coil. So it is also consists of a stylus probe. When the stylus probe moves over the surface, it induces voltage. Okay, this voltage is converted into, it is amplified and it is converted into electrical signal, and it is again converted into a surface roughness measure. Profile, this is a working principle of profilometer used in the measurement of surface roughness. Then Tomlinson surface meter. In this Tomlinson surface meter, and there is a diamond probe. There is a diamond probe, and the diamond probe along with the stylus is placed between the cylinders. Placed between the cylinders and two fixed rollers. Okay, so due to the movement of peaks and valleys, when it moves over the peaks and valleys, it rolls up and down. And this stylus arrangement is fixed by a leaf spring. Also, by it is connected to the helical spring, and an arm is attached to the stylus probe. So when there is a peak and valley, and the arm rotates up and down, the arm moves in the dial indicator, smoke glass. Okay, in the Tomlinson, this is called as a Tomlinson surface meter. In the Tomlinson surface meter, there are two rollers and the stylus, and the probe is connected because of the spring tension. Okay, because of the spring tension, they are connected. So when it moves over the peaks and valleys, it moves up and down, and that up and down movement is converted into the movement of the arm, and this correspond and this records and the exact surface roughness of an object in an enlarged scale. This is called as Tomlinson surface meter. Okay, then Taylor-Hobson-Telesurf. So Taylor-Hobson-Telesurf also works on the same principle. It consists of a probe and it is connected to the armature. So when the probe containing the skid moves over the surface, it moves up and down, and it is converted into electrical signal, and digital electronics techniques are used here to convert this signal into the surface roughness measure. This is called as Taylor-Hobson-Telesurf instrument. Which one of the following is not a direct surface roughness measurement instrument? Tomlinson surface meter is a surface roughness measurement device. Taylor-Hobson-Telesurf is a surface roughness measurement device. Profilometer is a surface roughness measurement device. And wireless surface dynamometers. Dynamometer is used to measure the torque. So answer is C. Then which of the following is not a surface finish measurement method? So critical angle of attack method, Tomlinson surface meter, Telesurf instrument, all are surface roughness measurement methods. Spectroscopy method is not a surface roughness measurement method. So answer is D. Profilometer is used to measure surface roughness. It does not measure the gear profile, or it will not be employed to measure the thread profile or flatness. It measures the surface roughness. So the answer is D. Profilometer is used to measure the surface roughness. Then V blocks are used in the measurement of in the workshop to check the roundness of a cylindrical workpiece. Roundness is defined as a condition of a surface or revolution where all the points of the surface intersected by any plane perpendicular to a common axis are equidistant from the axis. So any manufactured part cannot have perfect roundness because of limitations in the manufacturing process. So this is called as roundness. So V blocks are used to find the roundness. So we need a surface plate over which the V block is placed, and we need a dial gauge with a stand. The V block is kept on the surface plate, and cylindrical work part is positioned on the V block. The dial gauge is mounted on its stand, and plunger is made to contact with the surface of the work part. Okay. Initially, a light contact pressure is applied, and the deviations of dial indicator needle on both the plus and minus sides are noted down. Dial gauge reading is now set to zero. Now we have to rotate the workpiece over the V block. If it is of perfect roundness, there is a dial gauge will not move up and down. So if it has any out of roundness, as shown in the figure 10.13, if it has out of roundness, the dial gauge moves up and down. So the work part is slowly rotated, and the deviations of dial indicator needle on both the plus and minus sides are noted down. The difference in reading for one complete rotation. We have to rotate the workpiece for one complete rotation, and we can find how much it is deviated from the base circle. Okay, the initial inner circle, how much it deviates from the inner circle, and that value can be noted down. So this is a measure of roundness. So for measuring roundness, we need some 60 degree and 90 degree, two V blocks are used. 60 degree and 90 degree, two V blocks are used, and it is checked on. Two V blocks, 60 degree V block and 90 degree V blocks. Next question, the feature measured by gear teeth vernier is pitch line thickness of tooth. So gear teeth vernier, so gear teeth measurement. In gear teeth measurement, it is gear teeth vernier is used to measure the pitch line thickness of tooth. So tooth thickness along the pitch circle or pitch line thickness of the tooth can be measured by gear tooth vernier caliper. Then other methods are constant chord method, base tangent method, and measurement by dimensions over pins. Okay, tooth thickness along the pitch line thickness. Okay, the feature measured by gear tooth vernier is pitch line thickness of tooth. Okay, it is not addendum or total depth. Gear tooth vernier measures a pitch line thickness of tooth. Okay, so methods are gear tooth vernier by gear tooth vernier caliper, constant chord method, base tangent method, and measurement by dimensions over method. So this is a gear tooth vernier caliper. The gear tooth vernier caliper consists of two vernier scales. Okay, one horizontal vernier scale as well as one vertical vernier scale. So we don't know the pitch circle of the gear. It is not possible to calculate the pitch circle of the gear. For this, by calculation, we need to find the height of this block. One block is placed over the crest of the teeth, so flange of the teeth, and this block height should be set by the vernier scale, by the vertical scale of the vernier, and the horizontal scale measures the pitch line thickness. Okay, we have to set the horizontal. There are two scales: horizontal scale, which is represented in light color, and the vertical scale is represented by rose color. So this scale we have to set the, and there is a block inside, there is a block, and this block sets the height of the pitch circle. Okay, height of the pitch circle, and the horizontal scale measures the pitch line thickness of the gear teeth. Okay, pitch line thickness is the tooth thickness. Just it is a tooth thickness along the pitch line. It measures a tooth thickness along the pitch line. It is called as pitch line thickness of gear teeth. So it is conveniently measured by gear teeth. Gear tooth vernier has two vernier scales, and they are set for width of the tooth and depth from the top. So depth from the top is set by the vertical scale, and the width of the tooth is measured by the horizontal scale, each of which is adjusted independently by adjusting screw on graduated bars. So the depth of the screw is calculated by calculations. It measures the tooth thickness at the pitch line. Gear tooth measures tooth thickness at the pitch line. It can also measure caudal addendum distance from the top to chord. Only used to verify the theoretical measurements. Base tangent method. In the base tangent method, the limitations of gear tooth vernier can be overcome by measuring a span of a convenient number of teeth with a reviewed caliper. David Brown tangent comparator is used in this base tangent method. David Brown tangent comparator. The anvils in the comparator are first set of the base tangent length with the help of slip gauges. The distance is adjusted by setting the fixed anvils at a desired place with the help of rocking ring, locking ring, and setting tubes. Then slip gauges are replaced by a gear which is to be measured, and again the reading are taken by the comparator as shown in figure. Okay, so this is a measuring anvil. So this is a measuring anvil, and this is a locking nut, and this is a fixed anvil. So we have to set a convenient number of teeth, and it measures the pitch line thickness of 5 teeth here. 5 teeth can be measured, and individual tooth thickness can be calculated from this. Then constant chord method. The chord joining these points on opposite faces of tooth, which make contact with the mating teeth when the center line of tooth lies on this center line of the gear centers. Constant chord measured where the tooth flange touches the flange of the basic rack. Okay. Then next instrument is Parkinson gear tester. In the Parkinson gear tester, there is a carriage. The gear wheel under test is placed in the place over this carriage, and there is a master gear wheel, and there is a movable carriage, and there is a calibrated spring, and a fixed carriage. So one carriage is fixed carriage over which master gear wheel is fixed, and this is a gear wheel under test. Mechanical dial indicator is placed, and any deviation can be measured using this mechanical indicator. The two carriages on fixed and movable are mounted on the base. A movable carriage is spring